If you are thinking about egg freezing but feeling overwhelmed with lots of questions, you are not alone. Every day, thousands and tens of thousands of people ask Google questions about egg freezing. Every day, I get DM'd questions on Instagram, on YouTube, on TikTok about egg freezing. And I've compiled the top 10 questions about egg freezing, and I'm going to answer them for you today. I'm Dr. Lora Shahine. I'm a double board certified OBGYN and reproductive endocrinologist helping people freeze their eggs and do fertility preservation for years. And I am here to educate and answer your questions. If this is the first time finding my channel, welcome. Be sure and subscribe so you get my weekly videos all about reproductive health. There's two other ways to stay in touch and learn. Number one is my weekly newsletter. You can sign up in the link in the description below. You can have fast facts about fertility in the news, and recommendations every single week. Another way to stay in touch and learn is my podcast. It's the Brave and Curious podcast, and you can listen anywhere you listen to podcasts on YouTube, Apple, Spotify. It's a wonderful way with interviews with experts in the field and fertility warriors, and then deep dives into topics that you have told me you are curious about. And today I'm going to answer the top 10 questions that many people want to know about egg freezing. Let's get started. Question number one, what is egg freezing? Egg freezing is a process of preserving your fertility. It's really important to understand that age and fertility is all about age of eggs and sperm, but we are talking about eggs today. And as we age, as our eggs age, fewer and fewer of them are able to do all the complicated genetic changes that are required to fertilize with a sperm and turn into a healthy embryo that turns into a healthy baby. So as eggs age, it takes longer to get pregnant. Fertility treatments like IVF go down in their success rate, and miscarriage rate increases. So what we're thinking about doing with freezing eggs at a younger age is giving us options in the future. If you want to conceive later in life for any reason, your fertility is linked to the age of the eggs that you froze years and years ago, not your current age. The process of egg freezing is very similar to what people think about with IVF. You have some time to prepare and get ready, and then you're doing injections to stimulate the ovaries to recruit multiple eggs in one cycle, and you do an egg retrieval, just like people that do IVF. It's just that once the eggs are retrieved out of your body and they're in the lab, we don't fertilize them. We freeze them on the day of the egg retrieval, and they are ready for you whenever you are ready to use these eggs, whether it's in a year or in 10 years. Question number two, why would you want to freeze your eggs? You want to freeze your eggs because you want to keep your options open for a family, but you don't want to get pregnant right now. There are many reasons that people freeze their eggs. It was traditionally offered only to people with a cancer diagnosis. They were getting ready to do treatment for their cancer that could really harm their eggs in the future, chemotherapy, radiation, maybe surgery and the reproductive organs, and they were worried about maybe not being able to keep the ovaries. If you can go through an ovarian stimulation process and freeze the eggs, then that person could proceed with their cancer treatment. And when they are in, you know, remission and ready to start their family, they have eggs ready for them, because in the future, they might not be ovulating anymore. Sometimes cancer treatments put people into menopause, and this egg freezing process really keeps options open. Now, that process has been opened to anybody that is not ready to have a child right now, but wants to keep options open for the future, and they are educated about the relation between age of eggs and fertility. So people could freeze their eggs because they are diagnosed with a chronic illness, not just cancer, but maybe significant endometriosis that can impact your fertility, especially over time. Maybe they've been diagnosed with rheumatoid arthritis or some sort of chronic autoimmune issue that might impact their fertility. So maybe some sort of medical reason why they're worried about their fertility in the future. But also, people freeze eggs because they just are not ready to have a baby right now for whatever reason. Could be that they're not partnered, could be that they just aren't ready and they are partnered, doesn't matter. If you are not ready to have a baby right now, but you want to keep the options open in the future, something to consider is freezing your eggs. Question number three, what age should you freeze your eggs? There's different opinions on this. If you freeze your eggs at a younger age, they're going to be mostly high quality eggs and you need to freeze fewer eggs in order to have a high success rate predicted in the future. If you wait and freeze your eggs at an older age, it's going to take more eggs, maybe more egg retrievals, to get a higher number of eggs to help you have a higher success rate predicted in the future. The studies that have tried to look at a cost-effective analysis of this, thinking of if you freeze eggs at a younger age, that's great. You need fewer eggs. Maybe you need fewer egg retrievals, but you're probably paying for storage for a long time. And also, if you freeze your eggs at a younger age, there's less likelihood that you're going to use them versus freezing eggs at an older age where you need multiple egg retrievals to get a high number of eggs to predict success in the future. But there's a high likelihood that you might use them because you're maybe closer to that time where you're thinking about starting your family. So cost-effective analysis studies really suggest that the sweet spot is age 32 to 36. So that's based on other people. That might not be the right time for you, but this is a general feeling that maybe people could think about waiting until their young 30s to freeze their eggs. The worry that I have and the caution that I have is that really is assuming that somebody has normal, in air quotes, fertility or egg supply for a 32, 33, 35-year-old. So there are people that have diminished ovarian reserve or a low egg supply, and they find out in their 20s, and they're really glad that they did egg freezing sooner rather than later. There is no one perfect age for you. I think if you're watching this video and you're curious about it, it's something to consider just having a consult and learning about your options, maybe getting a fertility checkup and sort of seeing what your egg supply is like, getting this information and reviewing with your doctor what the right age is for you. Question number four, how many eggs should I freeze? So this goes along with age. As eggs age, you need more of them to have a higher success rate predicted in the future. For example, if you're age 35 or younger and you freeze 10 eggs, you have an estimated live birth rate in the 60-70% range in the future. But if you're 40 years old, it can take freezing 20 eggs or more to get an over 50% rate of live birth when you go to use them. And I know that seems like a lot of eggs, but it's really important to understand attrition. Not every frozen egg is going to thaw. Not every thawed egg is going to fertilize with sperm. Not every fertilized egg and sperm, which is now an embryo, is going to make it to a mature embryo stage called a blastocyst. And not every embryo that is implanted is going to be a baby. And so it really can take a lot of eggs to improve your outcome in the future. And so part of a discussion with your fertility doctor before or after egg freezing is the number of eggs that you have and the predicted outcome for success in the future and finding the sweet spot that is right for you. There are egg freezing calculators online. One that I particularly like is from Spring Fertility because you can put in your age and you can put in the number of eggs that you have frozen and you get an estimate for live birth based on one live birth or two live births with the number of eggs that you have. And they actually give results from three different databases. So there's a range of outcomes. And I just think it's really good to not just get one sort of narrow view, but really look at sort of overall rates and talk to your doctor about this egg freezing calculator. There are other options online, but just being able to find that really empowers you as opposed to just assuming that five eggs is okay. It really might be. Five eggs could actually turn into a beautiful baby, but you really need to know at what age you have them frozen and kind of what that means for you. Question number five, what is the egg freezing process like? Well, it's basically IVF. It's learning, it's consent forms, it's getting medication, it's sometimes preparing the ovaries. Sometimes people will take birth control pills to lead into the cycle. And then it's about 2 weeks of shots and an egg retrieval. So everybody has, every clinic and every person has different protocols, but it's really typically about, you know, 10 to 14 days of shots. These shots are stimulating the growth and maturation of multiple eggs in one cycle. So when we do the egg retrieval is like ovulation, but we're getting those eggs out of your body before they ovulate. And so then we can freeze them that day. So the process is pretty much preparation, learning, then it's getting the ovaries ready with or without birth control pills, and then the 2 weeks of shots. And these can be 2 to 3 shots a day. Most often, they're subcutaneous shots, little tiny needles right underneath the skin. Talk to your clinic about the protocol that is right for you. Question number 6, are there any risks to doing egg freezing? Yes, any medical intervention has risks, but they are very rare, and it is considered a safe procedure. Doing egg freezing, you're not using up a resource you would use in the future. So if you get 12 eggs in one cycle, one egg retrieval, these are eggs that you would never use in the future. You are not going to go through menopause a year sooner. Whenever you do a procedure, you're probably going to get some medication to either get you very sleepy or completely asleep. There can be risks with anesthesia. We are putting a needle into those ovaries in order to drain the follicular fluid and get the eggs. And so anytime you're having a procedure on your body, there's risk of bleeding, infection, maybe damage to surrounding organs. Stimulating the ovaries, sometimes people have fatigue, bloating, discomfort, nausea. I mean, you're going through a medical procedure, and a really rare risk is that the ovaries really do get swollen and they twist on themselves. That's something called ovarian torsion. And finally, some people can get a really high stimulation, a lot of fluid shifts, and they might have something called ovarian hyperstimulation syndrome. So there are so many things that your doctor and your clinic can do to educate you, teach you, help with warning signs, choose the right protocol for you, be there for you if you're having any issues. All of these risks are possible, but they're very, very rare, and it's considered a very safe procedure. Question number 7, how much does egg freezing cost? It totally depends. You might have insurance coverage for some or all of the egg freezing process. You can ask your insurance coverage, your HR, for whatever company that you work for. You can look up coverage by state at a great website called resolve.org. Not everybody has coverage. And if you're paying out of pocket, the cost can be anywhere from $6,000 to $20,000. Now, I know that is a huge range. That is a general number that is sort of found on most websites. That lower end number, they're probably not including the cost of medication, which can be a couple of thousand dollars. And that $20,000, that's pretty much on the high end, but I'm sure that there are clinics that are charging that. So you have to ask your clinic and figure out exactly what the cost is for you. And we are really working as a community to try to increase access to care, including egg freezing and fertility preservation. But right now, not every state demands coverage and not every company provides coverage. Question number 8, does egg freezing guarantee a baby? The answer is no. I wish it did. I wish I could say that if you freeze your eggs, you are absolutely going to have a baby with those eggs in the future, should you choose to use them. But there is no way that we can have a crystal ball and know the future. We have come so far with this technology that the success rates are absolutely incredible, but nothing is 100%. So I do not talk to my patients about egg freezing being an insurance policy. I hear that a lot, kind of in sort of marketing and things like that. It's not an insurance policy, because in an insurance, you're guaranteed a payout. It is an opportunity. It's an investment in yourself. It is allowing for options in the future, but it is not a guarantee. Question number 9, do I have to take out my IUD to do egg freezing? Answer is no. Of course, you have to talk to your clinic and see what their protocols are. But in my clinic, Pacific Northwest Fertility in Seattle, we are not taking out IUDs, even hormonal IUDs that have progesterone in them, in order to do an egg freezing cycle. And question number 10, how long are the eggs good for? Like, do they get freezer burn? Are we on a timeline here? And quite honestly, they're probably good indefinitely, because they're frozen at such a low, low temperature in these incredible cryo tanks. There's a case report in the literature where a woman had a baby after her eggs were frozen for 14 years. That's the longest time that I could find that. But we have been freezing embryos for a lot longer than we've been freezing eggs. There is a case But there is a case in the UK where twins were born after embryos were frozen for 30 years. So really, theoretically, once they're frozen, they are good forever, you know, indefinitely. But the data that we have is one case report with an egg that was frozen for 14 years that turned into a beautiful baby. But if we're getting more and more data like we have on embryos, we could be hearing about eggs that were frozen for a lot longer than that and turn into beautiful babies. So let's recap. We just went over a lot of information about egg freezing, and I really hope that this information is valuable to you. We went over the top 10 questions about egg freezing, and I really hope that this clarifies a lot of information. I have more education on YouTube all about egg freezing, like how to choose a clinic, how to get prepared for your cycle, what to expect, recovery, lots of information. Look on my playlist. It's fertility preservation playlist. I hope this is helpful. Be sure and like this video if you learned something. Share it with a friend that you know that is thinking about doing an egg freezing cycle. Be sure and subscribe to this channel so you get my weekly videos all about reproductive health. And until next week, wishing you love, luck, and pineapples.